Let's see another topic, various methods of producing induced EMF. What is the major cause of inducing an EMF in the circuit? That is change in magnetic flux linked with the circuit. And if we look at magnetic flux, then magnetic flux by formula is BS cos theta. On how many factors does it depend? Magnetic field strength, area of cross section, and angle between normal unit vector and direction of magnetic field. Now, induced EMF by formula is minus d phi b over dt. Minus sign you can omit or remove, provided you are talking about only magnitude. So if you write not using minus sign, then it's okay. Minus sign automatically represents EMF is induced always in opposite direction. Now you have to change magnetic flux with respect to the time. So out of these three factors, magnetic field, area and angle, you can change one factor with respect to the time. Even then the magnetic flux linked with the coil changes and eventually EMF is induced across the ends of the coil. So how many methods can be there? By changing magnitude of magnetic field, number one, by changing magnitude or magnetic field strength with respect to time, number two, by changing angle between normal unit vector and magnetic field, and third, by changing area of cross section of coil. So follow either of the method, you can induce an EMF across the ends of the coil. By changing magnetic field, how can you change magnetic field? In this case, easiest method is pass on alternating current. That will be your next chapter. Pass on time-varying current through a coil. When you pass on a time-varying current through the coil, keep any other coil near to it, and EMF is induced in the other coil. Right? So by changing magnetic field means, you can change magnetic field by changing current, magnitude of current with respect to the time. So it is easy, not much effort you have to do for this by changing an induced EMF. Sorry, by changing current flowing through the coil. By changing angle. Now question arises, how do you change angle? It is also very simple. This is a coil suspended in magnetic field, or this is a coil suspended in magnetic field. You keep on rotating constantly this coil in presence of magnetic field. You will find the magnetic flux linked with the coil is changing. Right? So the magnetic flux changes even by rotating the coil. That's what you have seen. Actually, it works in case of AC generator and DC generator. Short and small models you must have seen in lower classes when you have made it, that a coil is rotated in uniform magnetic field, or coil is kept in between two poles and rotated in uniform magnetic field. It always induces an EMF. Third is by changing area of cross section of the coil. This is interesting. So So I take an example that there is a magnetic field acting perpendicular to the plane of the white wood inside. This representation we have already taught you. And there is a rectangular coil whose one arm is movable. Whose one arm is movable. Say this PQ arm is movable. And we can say RS fixed arm, length of the this side is L. Now move this PQ arm with constant velocity inwardly. So after some time it reaches to a new position P dash Q dash, distance traveled is delta X. So if you want to calculate change in area by moving movable arm or free arm of the rectangular wire frame PQRS, that is, you can write like this, then change in area delta A is equal to minus L into delta X, you can write, because actually area is decreasing while you are moving this arm inwardly with constant velocity. Therefore, change in magnetic flux, that is delta phi B is equal to B into delta A, that is delta phi B is equal to minus B L delta X, dividing both sides by delta T. Dividing both sides by delta T. That is delta B phi B over delta T is equal to minus B L delta X over delta T. Delta X over delta T by definition is what? Minus and minus equals to minus and minus. That is induced EMF is equal to BLV, because delta X over delta T is V. So this is a formula for obtaining induced EMF. I gave you an example by changing area for a linear arm or linear conductor. Not necessarily that you have to look forward, if it is circular loop then how it is changing. But you can vary magnetic flux link with the coil by changing area like this. Let's do now motional EMF. Motional EMF. What is motional EMF for electromotive force? When a conducting rod is moved through a constant magnetic field, then an EMF is induced across the ends of the rod. This induced EMF is termed as motional EMF. And of course, this motional EMF is also a consequence of electromagnetic induction. When magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, then EMF is induced. Consider a rod of length L is moved in uniform magnetic field of strength B as shown in figure. This is a rod of length L which is moved with velocity V. Right? Constant velocity V. Say rod's ends are P and Q. When you move this rod, what will happen? There are the charges, electrons and positive charges, which are free charges are available inside the conductor. So because of the magnetic field, these charges will experience force. Direction of force, as you know, we have to find it out by what? Fleming's left hand rule. So use Fleming's left hand rule. Direction of magnetic field, direction of force on a positive charge, direction of velocity. Magnetic field, velocity, the force on positive charge will act towards P. So as a result, all positive charges will drift towards P, negative charges will drift towards Q. So when positive charges are accumulated at P and negative charges are moving and shifting towards end Q, there will be a potential at point end A will be higher than potential at end Q, as an EMF is induced. Now if you want to find the expression, you can find there's a force acting on charge due to magnetic field that we know F is equal to QVV. Once you know the force, then you can easily calculate the work done in moving positive charges. Work done in moving positive charges towards end P then work done is equal to F into length, that is PQ. You can say QVB into L, and what therefore induced EMF, induced or emotional EMF, E is equal to work done per unit charge, general definition of EMF or potential difference, QVVL over Q, it cancels Q, so E is equal to BLV. Similar expression you have obtained in this case also, as you have seen in case by changing area. Now there are so many things you can deduce by using it. Number one, if R be the resistance of a conductor PQ, then current I is equal to E over R, that BLV over R, equation number 4. Once you have calculated the current, then you can easily find the magnitude of force on a conductor. Magnitude of force on a conductor in magnetic field easily you can find this force will be equal to IBL. I is BLV over R into BL, so answer is B square L square V over R. And once you have find this, then you can also calculate power required to push a conductor with velocity V. So power required is F into V, that is V square L square V square over R. So that's how you can calculate then energy. If this gets converted into heat energy, then expression remains same, equal to the power, right? So you can write one more expression, the mechanical energy dissipated. Mechanical energy dissipated u is equal to I square r. I value you know from equation 4, that is b square l square v square over r square into r. So b square l square v square over r. This is will be energy. So many expressions are associated with this. Now let's do some interesting questions on it, based on whatever we have learned so far. You can see interesting experiments also. Some conceptual questions say a very interesting question. Say conceptual question, I can say there is a metallic sphere and there is a wooden sphere of same size, same mass, everything is same. This is metallic, this is wooden. Now these both are allowed to fall freely under gravity. Which will reach on the ground earlier? These types of the questions you have seen so many times. You will say the acceleration due to gravity is uniform, so obviously both will reach together because mass is same, so attracted by the earth same. Answer is no. So when you are involving other possible factors in the motion of any object which you have not done earlier, that's why we were looking forward this question only on the basis of gravity. No other factors are count, or all other factors you can say assume to be zero, like air resistance, like this factor which I am going to talk about it. See, when these two are allowed to fall freely under gravity, this sphere, metallic sphere, will reach later than wooden sphere. Now question, you will ask question, why will it reach later? Answer is very clear. This is a metallic sphere. When it is moved through or falls freely under gravity, Earth's magnetic field, vertical component of the Earth's magnetic field, it has to cross. And because of this magnetic field, an EMF is induced. Because when it is moving through a magnetic field, EMF is induced and hence current will start inducing in it. Right? As a result, and we know that induced EMF always have tendency to oppose. So therefore, this induced EMF will oppose the motion. So actual value of acceleration on metallic sphere will be less than g. However, the value of acceleration on wooden sphere will be g, because magnetic field is not affecting it, right? So this will reach later in comparison to wooden. Metallic will reach later, acceleration will be smaller than g. This question is sometimes also asked in the competition like this, when metallic and wooden sphere are allowed to fall, will the acceleration acting on metallic sphere be greater than g, less than g, equal to g, and cannot be no relation at all? Like these questions are also formed.